Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us discuss about cross-site scripting protection in AEM. The cross-site scripting, XSS, allows attackers to inject code into web pages viewed by other users. This security vulnerability can be exploited by malicious web users to bypass access controls. The actual attack occurs when the victim visits the web page or web application that executes the malicious code. The web page or web application becomes a vehicle to deliver the malicious script to the user's browser. Most of the time, the malicious scripts are injected through URL parameters, form parameters, get or post parameters, cookies, and HTTP headers. To mitigate the XSS scripting issue, the input and output data should be escaped and filtered. Mainly the output escaping and filtering is critical. Escape any output data sent to the browser. Preventing cross-site scripting is the highest priority during both development and testing. AEM applies the principle of filtering all user-supplied content upon output. The XSS protection mechanism provided by AEM is based on the AntiSamy Java Library provided by OWASP. AntiSamy is an HTML, CSS and JavaScript filter for Java that sanitizes user input based on a policy file. Refer this URL for more details on AntiSamy. So you can go into this osap.org URL. This will provide you with all the information you need in order to implement your security requirements. In AEM, the default AntiSamy configuration can be found at, let me show you that, under libs, CQ, then there is a folder called XSS protection, then config.xml. This enables all the XSS protection related configurations. It is important that you adapt this configuration to your own security needs by overlaying the configuration file. Let us now see how the XSS protection is handled in STL template. STL provides the proper context-aware escaping to all variables being output to the frontend. STL has inbuilt XSS protection. STL enables multiple context. When you use context equal to unsafe, it disables escaping and XSS protection completely. Once XSS protection is disabled, your site may be vulnerable to cross-site scripting. To protect against cross-site scripting vulnerabilities, STL automatically recognizes the context within which an output string to be displayed within the final HTML output and escapes that string appropriately. It is also possible to override the automatic display context handling with the context option. So you can specify the context explicitly. So you can see here there are multiple contexts, HTML text, then script string, style token, there are multiple. There are times when none of the other context provided by STL will suit for your needs, and using unsafe context would be the last resort. But obviously this will disable the XSS protection as we discussed and is not recommended to use. Let me show that. If you see here, I am trying to print some data. The first one is properties, then JCR title. So explicitly I am saying the context as number. So the default context for this case is text, but I am saying it's number. So we can see their behavior. Then there is a URL link. Then href, I'm having some special characters in the query parameter. Here I'm not specifying any context. So the default context going to be URI. Then here again, I am specifying some script. Then and I am saying the context as HTML. So let's see the behavior. If I access this page, you can see here like the first one is printing a number 0. So because that actual data is text, but I'm saying the context as a number. So it's not matching. So the behavior will be like it will display 0. Then next one is like the link with some special character query parameters. So it's not considering this as a valid link. So you can see like the href parameter, attribute is filtered. So there is no href attribute. The next one is we specify some script. So here again, the script is filtered. Let us now see how to escape and filter the output for servlets. By default, Java responses are not filtered through XSS filter. Use this link XSS protection API to escape the output data while sending to browser. Refer this URL for more details on Sling XSS API So let me show you that. Yeah, this one. This enables multiple methods to escape the output, also to get the valid output data, and to filter the HTML based on XSS rules. If you see here, encode for CSS string, then encode for HTML attribute. So same way, you can have something called filter HTML, so that you can filter the HTML based on the XSS rules. Then even you can get a valid data, valid CSS color by passing the required data. Let us quickly see the demo. I have a servlet responding the HTML data. So if you see here, yeah, this is a sample servlet. So responding HTML data. Also using the XSS API to filter the HTML before sending to browser. You can get the XSS API through at reference here, XSS API. Then you can use the required methods. This have multiple methods as we discussed earlier. If you see here, I am having an attribute with name test, but this is not a valid as per the default XSS rules. So let me access the servlet now and see the behavior. If I go here, yeah, maybe let me access this. Yeah, if you see here, like gate, this test is filtered. Now let me go to the log. So this will say this. Let me come. Yeah, if you see here, HTML to HTML content context, anti-summy warning. The A tag contained an attribute that we could not process. The test attribute has been filtered out, but the tag is still in place. So it means that test attribute is not valid for that element. So it's filtered out. Let us now quickly see how to override the default anti-summy config file based on our requirement. As discussed, the default config file is placed under libs folder. Let me show you that. It's over here, libs, CQ, then XSS protection, config.xml. So overlay this to apps CQ XSS protection config.xml. I already overlaid here. So this is my config.xml. Enable new rules either to allow or restrict the data. Here I am modifying the configuration to allow the test attribute in element A. So for that, as a first step, create a new attribute definition in the file. So I'm just showing here, then I can copy here. Yeah. Attribute name test, then regex, what is the accepted value. Then enable this test attribute as a valid attribute for element A. So for that, let me search for test. Yeah, you can see here, this is the tag name A, then action validate. I'm saying attribute name test also valid attribute. Let us quickly see the demo. Let me quickly replace the configuration. Copy this, yeah, go here and paste it. Fine, let us now test it. What is the behavior difference? Yeah, now if you see here, I am able to see the attribute test equal to test. The anti-summy API allowing this specific attribute because we whitelisted this. Same way, even you can restrict based on your project requirement. Even in the servlet, you can use different methods because right now we used this filter HTML. So even you can use other escaping methods or get valid URL or valid data methods. Escaping the output data properly helps us to mitigate the XSS attacks. But still, you can apply other layer of protections to filter the incoming data. Let us see some of the options. The first one is X-XSS-Protection HTTP header. This header is designed to enable the cross-site scripting filter part of modern browsers. So most of the modern browsers has this XSS filter. This filter is usually enabled by default, but through these configurations, you can enforce it. So this takes multiple values. 0 it means it disabled the XSS filter, 1 means enables the filter, and if the cross-site scripting attack is detected, so to stop the attack, the browser will sanitize the page, but still the page is displayed. Another value is like 1 along with mode equal to block, so this again enables the filter, so but rather than sanitizing the page when the attack is detected, so the browser will prevent rendering the page to the user. So this is the way you can enable it in the dispatcher, the Apache header always set, then X-XSS protection, one, then mode equal to block. Another protection layer is Apache redirect rules. So Apache redirect rules can be used to restrict the website URLs with invalid query parameters. So you can refer this specific URL. So this gives the details on how to use the redirect rules to block the incoming request with invalid query parameters. Here you are enabling the required redirect rules to block the incoming request with invalid query parameters data, maybe data related to XSS scripting. Another protection layer is dispatcher filter rules. Dispatcher filter rules help you to filter the unwanted traffic reaching the publisher servers. So allow list are the better way of providing access control. They assume that all access requests should be denied unless they are explicitly part of the allow list. This model provides more restrictive control over new requests that might not have been reviewed yet or taken into consideration during a certain configuration stage. If you see, this is the default filter configuration. So here we are saying deny everything. So star, so it's like everything is denied. Then you can whitelist or allow the required URLs. So CRX system, this based on your environment, whether non-prod or prod. So based on that, you can enable the specific URLs, and also that is required for your website to function. Next one is Smart Security in Apache. Smart Security is a free web application firewall, WAF, that works with Apache, Nginx, and IIS web servers. It supports a flexible rule engine to perform simple and complex operations, and comes with a core rule set called a CRS, which has rules to prevent SQL injection, cross-site scripting, clickjacking, and lot of other exploits. For Apache, it's an additional module which makes it easy to install and configure. Mod security can potentially block common code injection attacks, which strengthens the security of the backend server, in our case, publisher. Refer this URL for more details on configuring Mod security module with Apache and enabling the rule sets. You have multiple articles in internet, but you can refer either one, so with the details to configure the Mod security with Apache. Another option is external WAP solutions can be configured in front of the application servers, in our case dispatcher, to filter the malicious traffic reaching the backend servers, AEM publishers. A WAF or web application firewall helps to protect web applications by filtering and monitoring HTTP traffic between a web application and the internet. It typically protects web applications from attacks such as cross-site forgery, cross-site scripting, file inclusion, SQL injection, and others. By deploying a WAF in front of web application, a shield is placed between a web application and the internet. The traffic, only the allowed traffic will reach to the dispatcher. All other malicious traffic will be filtered by this WAF. WAF is a type of reverse proxy, protecting the server from exposure by having clients pass through the WAF before reaching the server. WAF operates through a set of rules, often called policies. These policies aim to protect against vulnerabilities in the application by filtering out malicious traffic. There are multiple external WAF solutions available in the market. Most are cloud-based and paid solutions. Some are Cloudflare WAF, AWS WAF, Akamai WAF, FI Essential App Protect, Microsoft Azure Web Application Firewall. So based on your website criticality, you can deploy the external WAF solution to protect your website, because this is a paid solution. XSS protection is critical to protect the websites against the security attacks. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.